So children, let me share the screen for the session today. Today we are going to continue our discussion on congruence of triangles. Two more congruency conditions about triangles, congruency of triangles, that those are SSS congruence and RHS congruence. Yesterday we have seen three problems, but let me repeat the third problem so that you can understand better. Now we are moving on to the screen share. This is the third question, children. Third question is an important one even for class 10th. There also you have similar type of problem, but not congruency, some other with some other name it comes, it is called similarity. There in class 10th you will see this. So what is given in this question? Let us understand this. Here question: in triangles ABC and PQR, AB equal to PQ, that means the first side AB is equal to PQ here, and BC equal to QR, and median AM is equal to median PN. You know, median is a line segment joining a vertex and the midpoint of its opposite side. So M is the midpoint of BC. Similarly, N is the midpoint of QR in this triangle. Now we know that when M is the midpoint, automatically BM will be equal to MC. Similarly here, QN is equal to NR. Okay, let us see what we have to prove. In fact, we have to prove triangle ABM, this smaller triangle ABM and PQN. If you want, I'll color and show you these triangles A, B, M, and this is the triangle. I'll color it. Okay, and P, Q, N in this. So this way we will have P, Q, and N. These are the triangles to be proved as congruent. So to prove these two are congruent, we need to go for the comparison of the corresponding parts. What are all given? First thing, AM is the median. Let us start the reasoning from here. AM is the median in triangle ABC, therefore M is the midpoint. Just now I discussed this. And PN is the median in triangle PQR, therefore N is the midpoint of QR. We already know that BC equal to QR. BC equal to QR. That means half of BC is equal to half of QR, meaning half of BC is BM, half of QR is QN. So BM is equal to QN. This is what we proved first step. In the second step, let us start comparing the triangles now. Triangle ABM and triangle PQN. In this, AB equal to PQ, that is already given, and AM equal to PN, that is also given. You can see this. And just now we proved BM equal to QN. Therefore, triangle ABM is congruent to triangle PQN by SSS rule. What is the rule here? SSS congruence rule. Therefore, when these two triangles are congruent, we can also claim that this angle B is equal to corresponding angle Q in this triangle PQR. Now, first part of the proof is given. To be proved, first part is ABM, triangle ABM is congruent to triangle PQM. That's what we proved here. Now, let us try to prove the second congruency statement, triangle ABC and triangle PQR. It is easy now. Let us understand one after another. In triangles ABC and PQR, AB equal to PQ, that is given, and BC equal to QR, that is also given. And just now we proved the angle included between AB and BC in triangle ABC, and Q, that is angle between PQ and QR in triangle PQR, those two angles are correspondingly equal. They are corresponding angles and they are equal. Therefore, two sides and the included angle are correspondingly equal in these two triangles. Therefore, we have these two triangles are equal by SAS rule. Okay, so these are the logical proofs we have to give for the question given here. Now, those who missed it yesterday or those who could not listen completely due to any other problem, please note this problem quickly and we move on to the next problem. Okay, I'll give you half a minute time to complete noting down. Children, you may note in short only the proof, because given is there, RTP is there, and the related pictures are given in the textbook itself. Later on, you can see the textbook and copy those things. Only proofs you copy for every question. That is better. In this way, you can take down the notes faster, and time can be saved. Now, shall we move on to the next question? Yes.
Yes, sir.
Very good.
Yes, sir.
Sure.
That's good. That's good. Now, this is the fourth question here. What is given in this question? A triangle is given. A triangle is given. Triangle ABC is given, and BE and CF are altitudes. BE and CF are altitudes. Here BE and CF, they are altitudes. We have to prove that triangle ABC is isosceles. Now, what to do? We know that these two, BE and CF, they are altitudes. That much only is given. So, how to prove this one? We know that the angles are equal here, and I think they are equal altitudes. Let me check the textbook once. I think they are equal altitudes. Those who have textbook, quickly refer the problem whether equality is given or not. Let us check. 7.3, equal altitudes, two equal altitudes, BE and CF. Okay. BE and CF are, it is already given here, I am sorry. BE equal to CF, that means they are altitudes as well, they are equal. Now, to prove this, let us take the triangle 1 here, this one. In this, we know one of the parts, that is angle BEC. Okay, and triangle 2, we choose this one. In this triangle, this angle is equal to this angle. And we know that these two sides are equal, and this is a common side. And these two triangles are right triangles, you can observe that. Right angle triangles, one right angle is there in both. Okay, and one right angle, and opposite to right angle, the side is called?
Hypotenuse.
Hypotenuse are equal, because that is common hypotenuse for both, so that is equal. And one of the sides, that is altitude, it is nothing but altitude for this bigger triangle, BE, is equal to CF. So, three parts are correspondingly equal in these two triangles. So, triangle 1 and triangle 2. You can observe these triangles once again. Are you following? Akshaya?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Right. Yes, sir. Okay, Akshaya, right. Then, here, angle BEC is equal to angle CFB, EC is equal to 90 degrees, that is angle R, that is right angle, and BC equal to CB, that is common side actually, it is nothing but hypotenuse RH, and BE equal to CF, CB I wrote, CF I have to write, one second I will correct it. CF. Right. Now, that is also given, because it is BE equal to CF, that is first condition given. Therefore, three parts are correspondingly equal. There, one is right angles in both the triangle, and second part common is common side, that is hypotenuse, and third part common is one side in both the triangles, that is altitude of the triangle, altitude for this triangle. Therefore, these two triangles are congruent by RHS rule. when these two triangles are congruent, we can very well say BCE. First, let me check out these triangles. Then you can locate BCE. BCE, this angle, and another angle CBF, this angle. So those two are, these two angles are equal because they are corresponding parts of congruent triangles. Okay, now forget about these two smaller triangles, and look at the bigger triangle. These two angles are equal. When two angles are equal in a triangle, the sides opposite to them are also equal. That means opposite to C, AB, very good. AB is equal to AC. Therefore, AB's triangle ABC is isosceles. That's what we have proved just now. So question 4, I think you all have understood it correctly. So in this question, one triangle is given, two altitudes BA and CF are given, and that is given that they are equal. We have to prove that triangle ABC is isosceles. For proving that, we have chosen the triangles down below. One is BEC, another is triangle CFB. In these two triangles, already given that BEC is equal to CFB, each is 90 degrees because they are altitudes, those are right angles. And BE equal to CB, BC equal to CB, that is common side, which is opposite to the right angles, therefore it is hypotenuse. And BE equal to CF, that is given, therefore three parts are correspondingly equal. Those are right angles, hypotenuse, and sides of these two triangles. Therefore, those two triangles are congruent by RHS congruence rule. Okay, let me write the congruent symbol here. Equal to, I wrote. In this congruency, we have to write, here, instead of this equal to symbol, I have to put congruency symbol, that I will put here. Right. So, they are congruent by RHS rule. Therefore, corresponding parts BC equal to CBF. When you forget about these smaller triangles and look at these angles alone, then angle C equal to angle B, meaning opposite side of B is AC, AB is equal to opposite side of B, that is AC, AB equal to AC. Those are nothing but sides of this triangle. When two sides are equal, it is isosceles. So ABC is isosceles. This is how we proved this particular question. Now, let's move on to the next question. Hope you have all noted. Have you noted this one, Bhargav? Jaswant?
Yes, sir.
Very good.
Yes, sir.
Right. Now we move on to question number 5. Here is the question, and of course I will cut this view so that view can be enlarged. Algebraic view will avoid. A triangle ABC is given, that is, which is isosceles, with AB, side AB equal to side AC. We have to prove that AP is the altitude of triangle ABC. This is the altitude. We have to prove that this is the altitude. Okay, it is just drawn. It is also given. AP is also altitude of triangle ABC. When that is AP is altitude, angle APC and angle APB, they are equal. Each is equal to 90 degrees. What we need to prove? We need to prove that angle B equal to angle C. Of course, it is a simple activity. We use again the last congruency condition. What is that? RHS.
Second question, sir.
RHS.
This is second question, huh? I think question number is wrong, but let me check once. Okay.
Sir, this question is over, sir.
Not over, Amma. Not over, I think. No.
Not over.
Not over, but question number is given. I'm correcting, don't worry. This is question number 5. Okay. Here, printing. A small printing mistake, don't worry. Now, ABC is isosceles with AB equal to AC and AP is the altitude. These two are given. When AP is the altitude, angle APB is equal to angle APC. Both are right angles. We need to prove that angle B equal to angle C in this triangle. For that, let us take the first part of the proof. Here AP, the altitude of triangle ABC, it is making the triangle into two small triangles. Okay, one is APB, another is APC. We can compare them now. On comparing triangle APB and APC, we know that APB, this angle, this blue colored, is equal to APC, this green colored. Each is equal to 90 degrees because it is altitude. We already know. AB equal to AC, that is given. And AP is a common side. These two are right angles. And opposite to each right angle, the hypotenuse and a common side. So by RHS again, these two triangles are congruent. And when two triangles are congruent, the corresponding parts in each of these are equal. So these two triangles are congruent by RHS rule. And then angle B is equal to angle C because they are corresponding parts of congruent triangles. And we have proved this one. So it is simpler than the previous one. All of you make a note of this one quickly. One additional letter is also given here. I will cut that. Alright, this is how we completed this exercise. So, what are all the concepts we learned in this exercise? We used two congruence conditions additionally to the known congruence conditions in the previous concepts. So, we used almost all the four congruence conditions for triangles and applied them to prove the given mathematical statements in the questions in this exercise 7.3. One is conditions, one is SAS congruence condition, side angle side, and ASA or AIS is also used. Third one, SSS congruence condition, and the fourth one, RHS, right angle hypotenuse side congruence condition. These four congruence conditions have been used in these problems to prove the mathematical statements. Okay, with this we